Hey y'all, how y'all doing? Came in here on my live video waiting for a few people to come in. Can you do me a favor, just share the live? Get some more people in there. If you black and own a business, let's chat. Jump on this live too. I love our entrepreneurs. And even if you're not black and you own a business, jump in this live. I don't discriminate. But when you do come into the live, you know, do a thumbs up or a hi so I can know you're there. I see we got like 5 people on. Just shoot me a hi or a thumbs up or something. Just let me know you're there. I'm sorry, I'm just sharing with a couple other people. Appreciate you joining in this evening, too. I know it's probably really, really late over there. It's only 9 o'clock here in Hawaii. But I've just been on such a euphoric high horse right now. And I just had to come on here and chat it up with you guys, see what's going on with you, see how you doing. Gotta check in on you, you and you. So say hi and post any questions that you may have. And I will let you know what's going on in the world of Crackenton. Got a little background music in there playing for you. Yeah, that's me talking to myself. Woo! Yeah. Ah, I put that in there wrong. Ah, dope. And if you're watching this from the Crack in the Cup page, just chat in the comment. I would love to know where you're tuning in from. I can post that up on my screen here. And yes, where are you at? I need to know where you at. Where y'all at? Because I know for a fact y'all ain't sleep. I'll be watching y'all. Y'all ain't sleep. Y'all be up later than me. Just got some easygoing music playing right now just for your entertainment. It's probably annoying my neighbors. Hello, welcome. And if you guys don't see your comment, don't worry. I can see it. Don't worry, I'm gonna go live again in the morning when the majority of y'all get up, because I know it's late. Boy, y'all probably be out partying right now. I mean, it is Saturday night. So I do want to thank you guys who sent me, you know, the warm wishes, the speedy recovery, I am out of the hospital. As you can see, this is not my hospital room. It's actually my bedroom. So, quote unquote, my office. So, yeah, I'm out of the hospital, doing much better now. Still taking it easy, though, making sure I'm not applying too much pressure on this stub. So, yeah, for those of you who don't know, I am an amputee. Half of my foot is gone, as well as half of my leg. But I've never let that stop me from doing what I want to do. And don't forget your cracking cup here.
Yeah,
she's still cute. But yeah, so a lot of things has been going on. Got sick on Sunday. I actually thought that I had contracted COVID because the way I was feeling while I was at work. And it was literally after having an interaction with a customer, with a homeless guy. He frequented our store quite a few times. But nevertheless, he came in there, you know, he placed his order respectfully. He wasn't off the wall or anything. However, he had a horrible, horrible cough. I mean, his cough was so bad when he coughed, like his mask flew off his face. And me, being me, I jumped back immediately because I was not vaccinated at the time and I was not pro-vaccination, not for any political reasons or anything like that, just because I just wanted to wait to see more people get it and see what the results was before I just jumped on the bandwagon and got it. But I definitely took every safety precaution there was to make sure that I do stay safe during this time, just like many of you. But with that, the guy scared me enough, and I think that brought on some of the panic with myself. So I did wind up going to the hospital later on that day. I was right in the middle of my shift, and I do like 10 to 12 hour shifts with Wendy's. So, yeah, that wasn't good. Like, I was only halfway through my shift. I still had like 6 hours to go. Immediately started feeling flushed in the face, hot, cold, chilled, shaking, body aching. I mean, it was just horrid. Did not realize at the time, which I found out when I went to the hospital, that my leg was actually bleeding. It was fluid coming off my leg as well. So that's what kind of kept me in the hospital a bit longer, because they wanted to make sure it wasn't the sepsis infection. But they gave me the COVID test. It came back negative, and I was so over the hill thrilled, because I was just more concerned that I may have contracted COVID in the line of work. But I didn't, so I was really happy about that. So fast forward, I'm at the hospital. We get all my tests was coming back. After they get me my antibiotics, I started feeling a whole lot better. Maybe like by day two and a half, I was ready to go. I was ready to go. I felt good that I was able to recognize the signs of what I was going through, so that way I was able to address this issue before it became more problematic. However, I felt very unsupported with my management team. Now, I am actually a general manager, so it was more alarming that I had no support that day. And when I called out for help, it fell on deaf ears. So, you know, it kind of left a bitterness in my mouth, and I really have been contemplating, what do I really want to do at this point? So I've always been working in the background with Cracking the Cup, as you guys see and know of. I'm always pushing and promoting Cracking the Cup, but I will say for about 7 to 8 months, I kind of was lax, and I was not pushing as much, and I was just relying on, you know, those who are currently purchasing from us to just be what it was. And, you know, it wasn't done because I didn't want to do my business anymore. It was done because I was trying to pretty much get myself in good health so I can be a rock star for cracking a cup. But my workload started getting very heavy. However, I've come to terms with me walking off my job and leaving Wendy's. Probably going to be doing some Uber Eats and some DoorDash in the in-between time to, you know, generate the money I need for my personal life so that way I can keep that going. But it's also going to give me that flexibility where I can actually take part in moving forward with Cracking a Cup a lot more. So if you saw my recent post on Facebook about the brighter days coming and just all the positivity that's been coming out of everything, I just want to say thank you, because you know I never stopped, never gave up on myself, and I got some information today because I was fighting with this food truck versus a storefront debacle. And you know, being here in Hawaii, you know, you got to be careful with the costs, because costs here is way more expensive than Chicago. So taking that into consideration, when I was weighing out the options for the food truck avenue lane or going the brick and mortar way right now, it was too top heavy to start with the brick and mortar. But in the essence of being creative and, you know, still being able to produce, I decided to go the route of the food truck. So I'm taking that opportunity right now. We got several different options. If you see a couple, about a year and a half ago, I shared with you guys a couple options of a food truck that I went to go visit. So I get to go back and go talk to him. I had to find a commercial kitchen space. I'm so happy I found one. It's actually very reasonably priced. I can actually see myself being able to say that's affordable. So that way I don't have to have a astronomically high product cost. And I think I'm going to enjoy doing this food truck mobile business right now. So Cracking a Cup is going to be Cracking a Cup mobile, because we're going to do the mobile option first. And as we develop and we grow our base, we're definitely moving to a brick and mortar space. That's definitely still on the horizon, but it's more taking baby steps at this time, just so it can be, you know, a greater outcome later. And it's just like the mentality of, you know, when you're born, you don't come out the womb walking. So I'm not going to come out the womb walking with this. I'm going to do what I need to do to generate the money that I need. I got a couple campaigns going on out there. If you see the one that's on the Refunder, that's the bigger campaign. That one is specifically for the brick and mortar location. That's why that one is $100 buy-in, but that is a loan. If you're investing in Cracking a Cup through that avenue, remember your $100 investment, that is a loan you're loaning to the company, payable within 3 years. So if you have some money that you would like to donate, jump on over here and go ahead and share that love. But yeah, so with the food truck being a feasible option, definitely a lower overhead and startup costs. So this is something that I can actually see coming to fruition within like the next 3 to maybe 6 months, depending on everything. Great thing about it, I use Square already, so I got my system in place for inventory control and, you know, POS system and everything. We're going to be using a couple of different other things as well, like we're going to be using Uber Eats. So Uber Eats did reach out to me, and they did, and I did let them know that it's a mobile food truck, and they actually work with mobile food trucks, so I thought that was fantastic. So I'm happy to say that we'll be able to get mobile offers, which will increase our brand recognition and bring in more revenues, and then we can reach more people. We're definitely going to be doing a little celebration, as I love to do. As you know, hey Sherry. So as you know, I do love to do celebrations. I don't care if it's a big celebration or small celebration. I celebrate all my accomplishments. So, also, if you saw on Facebook where we did the Boombox location in Chicago, we did a miniature grand opening there. So, we'll definitely be doing something nice for that. How are you doing this evening, Miss Sherry? I appreciate the love. Thank you. So, with the upward motion right now, with the food truck as an option, Cracker Club is going to have a limited menu, of course. Our primary focus will be our iced beverages. We will still serve like espressos, lattes, cappuccinos if you want the hot drink. But in Hawaii, I don't know, people still drinking hot drinks. But it's okay because I love y'all. We will have, like I said, the cold drinks, but we're also going to be featuring the aged cold brew product. And you guys are seeing me talk about aged cold brew or ACB. That's just my company's cold brew coffees and cold brew teas. Those things are going to be so amazing, and I cannot wait for you guys to taste them. And if you saw in another post, I did say I'm looking for product testers. I was being legit with that. I look for people to taste my product and let us know, you know, what they think about it. You will be tasting the standard recipes that I have created, and definitely would love your feedback on that. So if you're local here in Hawaii, definitely shoot an inbox to Crack in the Cup. Let us know that you want to be on the product testers list, and then I'll add your name and we'll reach out to you and let you know where you can pick it up, or you will let us know where we can ship it to. You said me, definitely. Absolutely. I definitely would appreciate your input. I know you are a connoisseur of types, so that would definitely be appreciated, Miss Sherry. But yeah, I'm super and uber excited. I'm actually working on the food line because, yes, we're going to have food on the food truck. I mean, come on, you can't really have a food truck without some kind of food. So some of the options that I am looking into, though, is paninis, salads, certain sandwiches that I've created. I would really like to bring the waffle sandwiches here to Hawaii. I'm going to reach out to Waffletopia. I know they closed down, but I know they still got some business. I know we don't stop just because we have one setback. So I'm going to reach out to them and see if maybe they had restarted their venture. And if so, I need to get their waffles. Excuse me. So I would love for you guys to try out Waffletopia. That's a husband and wife team I met at Coffee Fest. Yay! So yes, that's another exciting thing. I am booked for Coffee Fest. I cannot wait. It happens November 4th. Oh, sorry, I'll be leaving on November 4th. The festival actually starts on the 5th, and it goes until the 6th. So that's going to be in Portland, Oregon. So if any of you watching this, if you're going to be in Portland, Oregon, or you're going to be attending Coffee Fest, let's link up. We need to have a conversation. I'm excited about that because that's where I go to learn more about the industry. And this is how I get to be able to immerse myself in this industry, to learn the ins and outs, know what works, what don't work, what's new on the market. So this is going to be, as I say, dope-tastic. Cannot wait. But yeah, so other than that, the food truck option that we do have is going to be through 808 Kitchens. He's given me some great options to look at. Chanel has actually found things called Hawaii Carts. I gotta look them up because I want to make sure we maximize every single red penny that's coming out of this account, because I am not playing at this point. I have downgraded my life. I have taken away a lot of my amenities and my comforts just so I can make this happen. And I'm excited to do so. Gone through a lot of pain. I still got a lot of pain I got to go through, but that's okay. But I'm just uber excited and I cannot wait. If you do see a poll that I have out either on TikTok, Facebook, Instagram, whichever one it is, please chime in on those. I use that information to kind of shape and mold Crackin' Cup. Like learning what you guys like. Like, I know out here in Hawaii, food is big business out here. And if you have a good product, you can make some good money. But if you have a great product, you can make great money. So I look to have the line wrapped around that food truck like we did at the Taste of Black Chicago back in 2016. So yeah, I do anticipate great buzz. I'm going to start doing more social media posts as we get closer and closer to the date of opening. We're going to actually pay for radio advertisement because I'm going to blow this sucker up. If you sell or make promotional items that can be related to Crackin' the Cup or something that kind of coincides with us, please reach out to me. Let me know what it is that you're offering, because I definitely need some promotional giveaways that make sense to the coffee industry. We are going to be doing some giveaways of our coffee and our tea blends. I have all that stuff in the works. It's coming, so I cannot wait for that. As always, you know, I always give opportunity for people to try out the product for themselves. I've never been opposed to letting people try us, because I mean, the only way you're going to know if you like us is if you try us. And if you want to try it, I can send you a little 2-ounce sample and get you a taste and let you see. But I'm telling you, once you taste it, you're going to be hooked. I can guarantee that. If you haven't already as well, you can go to the website you see trickling down there at the bottom of your screen. Yeah, go to that website. You can find out more about Crackin' the Cup. You can join our mailing list, our email list. You can create your membership on that. So on Twitter, we're doing a promo where we're going to give out one person once we hit 100 shares and 100 follows on that particular post that I put on Twitter. They're going to earn, or they're going to receive, a year's worth of coffee or tea. So that's going to be dope in itself. So you don't have to worry about it. We're shipping directly to you totally free. All you have to do is just share. If you've been a part of any of my past events, we definitely do giveaways. I've given away cash money. I've given away product. I've given away shirts, hats. I mean, whatever it is for people who support Crackin' the Cup. And I do appreciate that. But yeah, at any time, if you have any questions, concerns, always reach out and, you know, let's have that conversation. So another question that I do want to address, because I get this one all the time, and people ask me about the packaging. They would like to know how long the package lasts. Not the package, how long the product lasts in the package. So, if you're purchasing from Crackin' the Cup directly, I can guarantee you a few things. It's going to be fresh. That smell is going to be amazing through the package. And I can guarantee you freshness for up to 9 months. So I can definitely say that if you do not open that package, once you receive it, it will stay as fresh as it is the day we roast it and send it to you 9 months later. So I've tested it out myself. It does not lose any of its flavor impact. It doesn't lose any of the potency. But the shelf life, 18 months. If you don't open it, it's 18 months. But of course, at that time, it will depreciate with the flavor and the freshness. It won't taste as fresh as that first day made. And I would also like to say thank you to my suppliers, because they have been shipping this product out to you guys expeditiously. I was not anticipating to have orders be shipped out and received by our customers so quickly. So I definitely want to say thank you to my suppliers for that. They've been very instrumental with me, especially after going through all the health issues that I had and able to keep my company going. I am over here like appreciative. I really do appreciate their help. So that in itself is amazing. I even had some products shipped out here to Hawaii just so I can see how fast it's actually coming. And it came fast, even shipping here to Hawaii. Now, yeah, we pay a little bit more, but that's okay. But, yeah, I'm super excited. Today I got to go visit a local coffee shop out here who actually started out as a coffee roaster. I got to see the equipment that they use. I fell in love. I'm actually thinking about maybe doing some roasting myself personally at the shop once we get our first brick and mortar open. But I definitely want input on some ideas that I am thinking for the cafe design. Like, you know, I gotta think ahead. But I got some of these ideas written down. Some of them I haven't written down yet. But with me, I always enjoy peace and tranquil moments. So what I mean by that is, you know how you go to your yoga studio, you can do your yoga, you can just relax, have nice meditative music on. Yeah, I'm thinking about creating a zen space within Cracking the Cup for those moments that we need to just have a break from reality. I think that's going to be a very instrumental key part to some locations. Some other locations, I'm thinking about having a full-on salad bar. It would not be a self-serve salad bar. We would, you know, just have you let us know what all you want in that salad, and we would just prepare it for you. A few other options that we're going to be definitely having, of course, is some soups. We definitely will have some soups. I got some amazing soups that I want to try out on you guys. I think that's going to be more beneficial in Chicago. But even out here, they even eat chili. It's hot as chili. So, yeah, go figure. Yeah, I'm excited about that. Definitely going to have, you know, your Nun coffee or your Nun tea related drinks. Pepsi and Coke have both let me know that I can utilize them. I'm just trying to pick and choose which one I want. Maybe just do both, because I don't want to choose. So, cannot wait for you guys to try out the chillers. Chillers is just nothing but our blended drinks, our blended cold drinks. Chillers is just fantastic coffee or tea drinks. I am really working on perfecting the passion fruit and cream. That one is going to be no caffeine added. It will have cream added to it. So if you have a dairy intolerance, you would have to let me know. We could entertain some dairy-free option creamers as well. But yes, to answer the question about the ABC or ACB, someone put ABC in my inbox. Hold on, write it in there for you so you would know what it said. Okay, so I got that in here. So, ACBs. Age cold brews. The coffee version. Knock your socks off. I will advise not to consume the entire bottle. I have been told, and this is why I'm working to perfect the recipe. I have had someone tell me they stayed up for 2 days, going on three. After consuming the age cold brew coffee, the straight black kept them up, and I believe them because I've tried it. Straight black cold brew coffee from us will keep you up. Yeah, so if you want something that's going to keep you up, and it keeps you up, but you don't get the shakes or the jitters. It's just a nice even flow of energy. But I will advise you not to go driving either way go, because you just never know how your body's going to take. But the straight black cold brew. But if you do happen to get one of the flavored cold brew coffees, now, We warrant, we do use again, Reamer. Cannot stress that enough. So if you're on a diet or you're worried about counting calories, don't get the flavored Kroger coffees. I would just advise you to just get the straight black, and then you can add whatever mixture you would like into that one. And then that way you can kind of fine tune it to your life. You can have it come, it comes in unsweetened or sweetened for both, flavored or not. We can do the flavored version, but it has zero sugar in it. Just have the flavor profile there. Or you could just do the one that's pre-made with the sweetness in it. Now, most of our sweeteners that we use is agave. We do use agave to sweeten. So we do use the flavors that we add in there. And then it's sweetened by agave. And agave is was so important to mention that is because if you're diabetic, you have to be careful with your sugar intake. So we had this in the thought process while creating this drink. What can be beneficial to the diabetic community where we can help them out in some way where it's not going to skyrocket their sugar. Especially since I am a diabetic. So I did test this on myself, and I have found that agave sugar, it is sweeter, but it does not raise the sugar as quickly as your regular granulated sugar or sugar in the raw, also known as cane sugar. So with that, we definitely try to use more premium ingredients, more plant-based type of ingredients. And if you're asking why I'm using agave, it's because it's made from tequila plant. But they do make tequila out of that sugar tequila, or the plant that's used. But so that's why I use agave first. My second choice of sweetener is the honey in the raw. Depending on you can go to our website. You can, coming soon, I should say, request and customize those drinks. And we will brew it specifically to your taste and your likes. That is something new that we're doing. This is something most of my competitors cannot do because of the capacity that they have right now. It will be unrealistic for them. But because we're so new and we are testing the waters, I said, why not? We can definitely create this this little kitchen warehouse where we're creating these drinks custom fitted for your taste. The one thing I am working out is the shipping of this product because it is a perishable item. It will last you about a good week to 14 days in the package unopened. But I would definitely advise you to refrigerate it for two reasons. Last longer, tastes even better. I mean, you can't get a cold brew hot. Like, who wants a hot cold brew? But, how long do you steep your cold brew? Well, that depends on the blend. So, we're talking about the coffees, that is between 24 and 36 hours, and the teas can go up to 48 hours. Reason is because I want to extract the most caffeine for my coffees and my teas that has caffeine in it, to extract the most caffeine I possibly can, but it's going to be so flavorful. And when I say flavorful, I mean flavorful. You're going to love it. It's going to taste amazing. And it's going to have a more smoother, crisper taste to it as well. So, yeah, definitely want to try that out. But we're not going to have a really big variety of flavors. We're going to stick to our staples and what's worked for us. We're going to have your mocha because, I mean, you cannot have a coffee shop and have coffee drinks without chocolate. So, hands down. And I'm talking about bittersweet chocolate, too. We're going to have white chocolate as an option. Caramel or caramel, depending on where you're from. Vanilla, hazelnut is also going to be an option. And then, of course, a seasonal flavor. But those are pretty much our standard ones that we'll carry on a regular basis. For the teas, we're going to do the green, we're going to do the black, and we're going to do the passion fruit. Those are the main three that I will have available. And I'm also going to do the lemon mango. That one I'm testing out right now. So I'm going to see how that one fares. And if it comes out, you know, then we're going to add that to the list of the cold brew teas. I do not brew the ginger tea anymore. That one has become a really difficult one to brew cold, as I don't like the texture and the consistency of the way it comes out. So we won't be doing the ginger cold brew anymore. We'll just be focusing on those that I just listed. And then again, yes, you can customize your drinks online soon. I haven't put that part on the website yet, so if you go to the website and you don't see it, don't sweat. It ain't out yet. We're actually waiting for a product to come in, and we're waiting for my shipment of alkaline water. So yeah, that was the other key. It's alkaline water that we usually use. So with alkaline water, yes, it will cost a little bit more. Or we can always use the standard purified water. But whichever option we use, it's always going to have some type of filtered water in it. And if you go to a coffee shop and they're not brewing your stuff in filtered water, run! Do not stay, do not consume, do not pass go. Don't give them your coins or your ducats. Yes, so this has been a dope conversation, but I know again, I know it's late out there. I'm not going to hold y'all too much longer because I'm going to come back for y'all later on today because I do got to get out here and go make some coins. So keep following us, keep supporting us, keep sharing our content. I definitely appreciate it. And I'll see you in the comments. Y'all have a good night.